It's an honor to be here today and speaking on behalf of the Arizona Indian Gaming Association. In 1988, Congress passed the Indian Gaming Regulatory Act at the urging of Arizona's former Senator John McCain, recognizing tribes' inherent authority to offer Indian gaming subject to federal law. In 2002, we saw Arizona voters pass Proposition 202 that provided a form of tribal-state compact limiting gaming to Indian reservations and providing for shared revenue payments to the state. Since the passage of Prop 202, tribal communities throughout Arizona have enhanced their casinos' amenities to rival any of those found in Las Vegas. Tribal casinos and resorts provided over 15,000 jobs in Arizona and contribute approximately $100 million annually to the state through the Arizona Benefits Fund. In 2003, tribes have paid to the state nearly $1.7 billion that have been distributed to the terms of the Tribal State Compact to education, emergency health services and trauma care, tourism, wildlife conservation, and Arizona cities, towns, and counties. Over the last year during the global pandemic, the connection among people, business, and government have become even more pronounced. The effort to mask up, to flatten the curve, and ease the burden on the healthcare system has been a year-long refrain. Federal, state, local, and tribal governments attempted to protect citizens while balancing businesses and governmental interests. Tribal governments implemented mitigation efforts within our communities and made painful decisions to close businesses and limit activities to ensure the health and safety of our patrons, employees, and community members. Yet, like all of Arizonans, we suffered losses of life. No one has been spared from the pandemic. All the while, individual citizens, businesses, and governments attempted to balance healthcare concerns with Arizona's vibrant economy in an effort to ensure families would not suffer. We heard about the importance of the continued interaction of tribal businesses with our vendors and suppliers. Tribal nations saw firsthand that we are important customers to thousands of vendors and suppliers in our surrounding communities. In our efforts to reopen, we implemented enhanced safety protocols to ensure a safe, fun environment for patrons and employees. We sought to reopen our casinos and resorts and other tribal enterprises as quickly and safely as possible to not only provide funding for our essential government services, but to help jumpstart the Arizona economy. To that end, we are pleased that Governor Ducey has worked cooperatively with tribal governments to modernize the Tribal State Gaming Compact and to enhance gaming in Arizona to benefit all Arizona citizens. The benefits of Indian gaming will continue to follow to Arizona as a result of the amended Tribal State Compact. Over the last year, we saw the continuing powers of community and the connections between families, businesses, and governments. Families sought to help each other. Neighbors provided support to each other, and strangers helped strangers. Law enforcement and fire personnel continue to serve others at their own peril. Grocery store workers kept our stores open and stocked the shelves as best as possible as truckers delivered and unloaded precious cargo. Organizations provided meals, information, and forums for those seeking help. Restaurant workers continued to provide food service to families while delivery services delivered meals to nurture, comfort, and even provide a well-deserved break to those protecting our community. Nurses and doctors treated victims of the pandemic and battled an unknown enemy that required seemingly an unending shift away from family, friends, and life as they know it. Businesses banded together to provide PPE to their employees and to underserved communities and answered the call to pivot their business to meet the demand for PPE and essential products. Government, private businesses, and universities cooperated to research, develop, testing, and vaccines. Valuable information from these efforts resulted in new accurate testing, treatment, and vaccines in hopes of returning Arizona back to normal. We saw creative minds emerge and valuable experience in Arizonans of all ages, all wanting to do their part in battling the virus, comforting others, and protecting and serving you and me. Throughout the pandemic, we recognize your continuing efforts, selflessness, and resilience. To the frontline and all essential workers, we say thank you.